Hi, and welcome back to episode number 22 of No Title, No Name. And that's right, we are in a full 720p.
This is episode 22.
This is episode 22. But we're in a full 720p. I have a capability that's 1080p. We're going to try it out first on my new Kodak ZI-8. I got the black version, picked it up today, and has the external mic. So that will be my next purchase, is updating the audio so that we don't sound like
scream across the room.
Exactly. So, we're definitely in high def, and we're going to try this week 720, maybe next week doing 1080p, trying it out. But
soon we'll be good as that Gabby girl that we made fun of a couple episodes ago.
Juju or whatever her name was. Yeah. I don't know. But anyway, we appreciate all the comments that we had from that video. That was hilarious. But a few things to talk about this week. The Zoom phone, aka Windows Phone 7 Series. Anyway, I can't spit it all out. So, yeah.
WP7S.
Will you buy one?
No.
Why not?
Well, it's the first edition.
It's the first edition across many platforms. It'll be like the Google phone, where it's Android across the thing. It's not going to be just that phone.
Yeah. Well, some more questions will have to be answered.
Okay.
Like I was talking to you about. There's a lot of cool apps on this. If you haven't seen the video, we'll throw a link down that you can watch a video for it. It's got the touch screen. It's basically like an iPhone, but it's got Microsoft on it instead. But they've come up with some pretty cool ideas. They have what they call life squares, which I don't know. We have one here. We could show you. Maybe Rusty could put one right there.
No.
He won't.
No.
Okay. But it's got just squares inside of the screen, and it's got your phone, your friends. What's cool about your friends is if they happen to change their Facebook page that moment, it will automatically switch to that new profile picture.
Which the iPhone can already do.
I don't care either way, so I mean, you know. So, yeah. What I was saying is, some questions to be answered is, being Microsoft, it has Silverlight, yes.
Well, you did confirm that.
Seeing a couple of stories here, and also from some Microsoft execs, yes.
Silverlight runs Netflix, correct?
Yes. So if it has like a Netflix app, that'd be great.
Yeah, because then you can stream your Netflix stuff straight to your phone.
That would definitely sell.
Via your subscription, yeah. Because right now, the iPhone, actually, I'll talk about this later, but the iPhone can do Slingbox, which is cool. Now, you can do it over 3G instead of just wireless, so that's kind of cool. But, I mean, if Silverlight is... What else does Silverlight run besides Netflix? Nothing? Okay, there's your answer. So, Netflix, sponsored by, we'd like to be, but if...
But still, Netflix, I mean, you've got a lot to choose from there.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the only thing Silverlight plays versus Flash, which, you know, Hulu and everything else. But.
Yeah. Yeah, Microsoft did say Flash was not going to be on there because of the heavy... Flash puts a heavy deal on the CPU, on any CPU it puts on. And if you ever, desktop, laptop, whatever, you ever notice, you'll see your CPU cycles just go up and up and up when Flash comes on. So you just got to make sure you're watching out for that. And Silverlight doesn't do that as much. That's the reason why it's on the Xbox 360. It's on, I'm trying to think of anything else that plays Netflix. But, I mean, any of your basic laptops, they're not that bad. And, I mean, and you get great quality video, so.
Yeah. So, confirm a contract with Netflix, maybe whenever a new design. Also, like to see it, you know, a better design than this brick shape.
Well, the one that they're showing is because obviously everybody's bouncing off the iPhone.
Yeah, well, they need something to see too.
Exactly. So that was a demo phone, which Microsoft has said everybody across the board will have this high capacity touchscreen, 800 by 400 or something. I forget what the thing is, but they want that high def screen. It's not a high def screen, but it's a higher quality screen with the three buttons: the back button, the Windows start button, and then the search button, so that you can, you know, search, always go back, and then your actual menu button. So all those phones will have those three buttons across the bottom, and then you'll also have the Microsoft software and that high capacity, nice screen. So as long as you meet those requirements, you can call it a Microsoft, you know, Windows Phone 7 series. So.
Also, I never see them do this.
I think it'll have one. I wouldn't see why it wouldn't. I mean, every phone does that now. Even my Samsung Impression, which I just sold, it does it when you turn it. So.
Also, they didn't show a lot of, you know, just watching videos either. Which, that if you watch the story, it's basically, you know, Microsoft, they want to make a phone, not a PC, not a gaming unit, not a calculator. They want a phone to be a phone.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I just need some more questions answered.
Yeah, so we won't see it till come time Christmas, probably third, fourth quarter this year.
Mm-hmm.
But definitely, if it does come out before June, because apparently we're still waiting on the iPhone update because we haven't heard anything.
Yeah.
We're still stuck on the 3GS 3.14, whatever it is. Matter of fact, my 3G is still running on 3.0. It's doing just fine. I get my picture messaging and all that. But mine's jailbroken. But if they were to hurry up the process and get some out there, and I might consider switching to this, you know, 7 series phone if that's, you know, all that it's going to be doing. I mean, I want to try it out. Will I buy one right now? I'm with you.
Yeah.
Questions need to be answered. But if the iPhone has an update,
if they want to send a unit for us to test,
we'll always take test units. But speaking of the iPhone, also this past week or so, they have updated the capability of the phone where if you were on 3G and you want to download an app and the app was more than 10 megabytes, it would give you the little pop-up symbol and say, you have to connect to wireless to get this.
Mm-hmm.
Well, now they've upped that to 20 megabytes, so it's not much, but it's more, and I'm assuming because the iPad's coming out here shortly. They're going to have bigger apps, and so
they've got to handle it.
Yeah, they've got to be able to handle that. So now they will have the 20 megabyte, and also they've also just released the iPhone 3G Sling Player for the iPhone so that you can watch your Sling Box if you own one. You know, you get your cable in or your satellite or whatever, and you sling it out to whatever your receiver is. Well, now you can get it on the iPhone and watch your TV over the phone, which is awesome.
That's cool.
So if I had paid cable, which I don't, it would be great to, you know, spit it out to my phone and be able to watch live TV and change the channels and everything. But I don't have paid TV, so it doesn't seem that great for me. So that's awesome. But, you know, the other thing was, now, get this, everybody's going, oh, AT&T, you know, Verizon keeps throwing us down, keeps throwing us down, keeps throwing us down. And AT&T is like, well, we work here, we work there, we work here. PC World, independent contractor or whatever, went out and tested in 13 different cities and puts AT&T at the top almost every single time.
Of course. I mean, Verizon pretty much just owns New England.
Okay.
I mean, that's their, they've been there forever. That was their, you know, if you want a home phone, you go for Verizon. Then they, you know, jump in that wireless market, which they bought, I don't know, maybe they bought MCI or the Sprint. Well,
Sprint, MCI.
Sprint, okay, well, you know, then they just started to spread with that wireless. So, I mean, of course, AT&T, you can't beat it.
It's Ma Bell. It's been around forever.
Exactly.
So,
I mean, Sprint's got some nice things in the working, and they're wireless and everything, but, I mean, 4G, right now, I mean, AT&T is it.
I really do think there's a future with everything that's changing right now. Like, they're allowing voice over IP through 3G, which really you can just use the internet for your phone calls now.
Yeah.
That, and, you know, reduce your minutes. Plus, they're, you know, upgrading from 3G to 4G in the next couple of years. AT&T will be on the LTE, long-term exchange. I forget how it is, but it's 4G network for them. Mm-hmm. They'll be doing that in the next couple of years. So I think we're moving in the right direction. So, you know, I think all these issues that we have with the iPhone and AT&T will be going away, and, you know, everybody will just be fighting to keep those customers because, you know, I think Verizon right now is rated number one, but to be honest with you, I personally think AT&T is number one. They've got the best phones. They've got the best lineup, so we'll see how it goes. But that is that's what we got for this week. Anything else?
No. I guess not.
Okay. All right, well, that's the end of episode number 22. We'll see you again
in HD
next time for 23. No title, no name.